Esperanza, Julia, the sorry mess I had made of life. The years to come even now beginning to weigh down. To crush, they lost concreteness, diffused into formless melancholy.
Papa.
Hmm.
And when will the lobby want to sell?
I don't know yet. Alfredo is not very specific, but I understand Esperanza wants it to be next month.
Why is not Pete more decided? I wonder, he is over 30, isn't that? And he's still a bachelor. Esperanza must be tired quickly.
She does not seem to be in much of a hurry either.
How can a woman be in hurry when the man does not hurry her? Papa, do you remember how much in love he was?
In love? With whom?
With Esperanza, of course. He has not had another love affair that I know of. What I mean is that in the beginning, he was enthusiastic. Flowers, serenades, notes, and things like that.
Why would men so mismanage with their lives? Greed, the desire to crowd into a moment all the enjoyment it will hold. To squeeze from the hour all the emotion it will yield. Men commit themselves when but half meaning to do so. Sacrificing possible future fullness of ecstasy to the craving for immediate excitement. Greed mortgaging the future, forcing the hand of time or of fate.
What do you think happened?
I suppose long engaged people are like that. Warm now, cold tomorrow. I think they are other offer good than warm. The bare fact that eye engagement has been allowed to prolong itself argues a certain passivity of temper or of affection on the part of either or both. That pace you were speaking of is natural enough for a beginning. Besides, that I see it was Alfredo's last race with escaping you. A last spurt of hard blood. A little mental relaxation now and then it's beneficial. Besides, God's love me. You know it's a word rising of lawyer's trouble. Thank you.
How about you, Mr. Valle? You're so very different from the excitement of the judge's children, and you've just arrived. How is your stay here in our town?
It's just okay, such a beautiful place. Excuse me for a while, I'll just prepare some coffee.
Excuse me also for a while.
Alfredo, she was not the judge's sister, but the judge's sister-in-law, and her name is Julia Salas.
I'm so sorry for calling you all this time, Ms. Del Valle. That was so embarrassing. They have not formally introduced you, so I assume you were the judge's sister.
That is nothing. Each time I was about to correct you, but I remembered a similar experience I had once before.
Oh.
A man named Manalo. I kept calling him Manalo. After the 10th time or so, the young man rose from his seat and said suddenly, "Pardon me, but my name is Manalang, Manalang. You know, I never forgive him." The best thing to do under the circumstances, I have found out, is to pretend not to hear and to let the other person find out his mistakes without help.
As you did this time, still you look amused every time
I was thinking of Mr. Manalang.
Hello, good morning, Salazar's residence.
This is Esperanza.
Oh, Esperanza, when did you call?
I just want to ask if you went home after the Mass, because for several Sundays, you have not waited me to come out of the church.
Oh, I went home to work. Sometimes I go with Papa to Judge Del Valles.